Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about XP here in Fortnite Chapter 3. I did an XP video already this season. It got a ton of support, so I wanted to do another one just as a little update because I have found out quite a bit more about these milestone challenges and stuff. Like I said in my last video, milestone challenges are definitely the best way to level up, and I'm going to be going through those and showing you guys the best way to do them, and I'm going to show you guys some of the other challenges and some other things I found out about XP. So the first thing I want to talk about is I found out that the first 7 levels take less XP to level up. So basically, if you're going to buy tiers, don't buy the starter pack. The starter pack is basically kind of a scam. I mean, you get the first 25 levels immediately, but the first 7 levels aren't even full levels, so you don't get as much XP. So if you're going to buy tiers, make sure you wait until you hit level 7 and then buy tiers, because at that point it takes 80,000 XP per level, and the other levels before that take less XP. So basically, it's going to get you there faster and you're getting more value out of the money you spend. I definitely would never buy the Battle Pass bundle. If you want to know how to do that, basically after you buy the Battle Pass, go over here and buy this in the item shop, and you're going to spend exactly the same amount of money as you would have for the Battle Pass bundle. But basically, you just wait and you get more bang for your buck here. Now, I already talked about the daily challenges in my last video. I've been doing daily challenges every time. I don't think it's worth it to just get the supercharge because I'd rather get that XP sooner. Because like I said, we're trying to level up as soon as possible here. So I get them done the day they come out and I get 45,000 XP for doing them. And that's good enough for me, I guess. I'd like to see a buff at some point, but I understand it's the first week. Another thing I didn't know is that you get more Shanta quests as you go. So I end up getting a ton more. I thought we were waiting on them to unlock, but actually it says complete one more quest. So basically, as you do more quests, you'll unlock more of them. I thought we had to wait until the next set of them came out. So that's really cool. So that's actually a lot more XP from the Shanta quest than I thought. And the Shanta quests are actually really easy. You basically just go around collecting these little gems around the map. Very simple quest, very easy to get done very quick. They also added in these Gears of War quests, and they're all really easy. If you click on the quest, it'll actually show you the places to go on the map right here. And these are really simple and an easy way to rank up. And now I'm going to talk about the milestones and how I was able to get a ton of these done really quick. As you can see, I'm on stage 12 of the search chest of ammo boxes. I've already done all 20 of the harvest materials. I'm on 17 of the vending machine purchases. And in total, I have done 118 milestone quests, which is, I think, quite a bit for the first week. So I'm going to tell you guys how I've done some of these pretty quick. The search chests and ammo boxes, never break a chest. Always make sure you open it. I know it's quicker, and I know a lot of people that are going for wins, you know, they're going to break the chest because it's quicker. But as far as XP goes and getting these challenges done, you want to open every single one. The way I got harvest materials done so quick is I was going for the breaking trees challenge. So every time I'd keep breaking trees and I'd get to max materials, I'd drop half my wood and start harvesting some more and just keep going for it. Like, I'd never stop even if I was at max materials, just because I wanted to grind it out and get those challenges done because they're really easy. You only have to get 2,500 each time to get to the next stage. For the vending machine purchases, there's actually kind of a little workaround to make this a lot quicker. So make sure you go to a vending machine with gold, and you can get this whole set of challenges done with only 2,000 gold. So basically, you're going to go to a vending machine, and you're going to go to the weapons ones and go buy ammunition. So assault rifle bullets only cost 10 gold, and shotgun bullets are 4 gold. So if you can find the shotgun bullets, it's a lot quicker. But if you find the AR ones, they're just as good too. You can go ahead and buy those out real quick. And I've already got 160 of these done, and you need to get to 200. So those are really easy. Thanking the bus driver is pretty obvious. You just thank the bus driver every single game. Obviously, I've played quite a bit this season already, 136 games. Elimination's another easy one to do. Damage opponents, they actually set this really low. You only have to get 100,000 total damage, which adds out to about 1,000 eliminations, not counting like shield and stuff. So when they get shield, I mean, it's a pretty easy one to get through, especially if you go ahead and play Team Rumble, you can get through that really quick. So that's probably the way I'd recommend to get done with that, is playing Team Rumble. And that will help you with both your eliminations and your damage opponents. Destroying trees is actually one of the harder ones. I've been spending so much time destroying trees, and they take forever to get through because 250 trees is a lot of material. That's why I was able to get to stage 20 of harvesting materials before I even got to stage 5 of destroying trees, because it's just so much destroying trees, dude. It's a lot. So I don't think you're going to be able to get every single one of these quests done, but you can get quite a bit of them, and I've gotten quite a ton of XP, man, to be honest. If you want to open vaults and solos, you can pick up one of these 7 guards and take them down to the vault and it'll open it for you. Crafting items actually hasn't been added to the game, but once that does get added to the game, that's going to be a really easy quest because crafting items, it's really easy. As long as it's the same system as before, it should be really easy. And then complete bounties. I actually don't do the bounties. I just go up to the bounty board and accept it. And then if they get eliminated, I get the challenge done. If they don't, whatever. But I'm not going to spend my time doing the bounties. I just accept them and let somebody else get the elimination. And then I get the credit for it. So that's what I would do if I were you guys trying to complete the bounties. Another thing is I did think imposters was good for XP, and then they ended up nerfing imposters XP again. So it's a nerf on top of a nerf. So imposters really isn't very good for XP unless you're basically playing with friends and just playing for XP, which honestly I don't think is very fun, just going into imposters and just calling the Peely party over and over again. A lot of people do that. I don't think it's a very solid strategy anymore now that they've nerfed imposters again. And honestly, considering imposters has had the same map for a while, I think this game's probably gonna have less players in imposters just because they've been ruining the XP in it. There hasn't been any big updates since it came out, so I don't know. I haven't been playing it lately. I'd like to see a new map pretty soon, but we'll see how that goes. Another thing that they added this season is you can get XP in creative mode. Now, I'm just going to say this once. If you look up XP creative, you're going to end up finding a bunch of glitches. And me personally, I wouldn't do them just because I don't know if you can get in trouble for it or not. I don't do them. I just try to stay away from those completely just because I don't trust it. We've seen things that weren't against the rules before become against the rules later, and then people get banned for stuff they did in the past. So I don't want to be a part of that at all, and I don't want to promote doing it just because I don't want to promote anything to you guys that could get you in trouble, and it's something that I wouldn't do. So I feel like I probably shouldn't tell you guys to do it. I definitely wouldn't. And honestly, what a lot of people don't know is a lot of those glitches you'll see on YouTube actually have a cap. So once you get a certain amount of XP, it stops you from getting XP anymore, and Epic patches those glitches really fast. So none of them really stay. Like if I made an XP glitch video, it would be outdated like the next day. But getting XP in creative the normal way actually isn't a bad idea. You can get quite a bit of XP just by playing like Zone Wars. Like I was playing this one map, I got 300 XP per chest, and I got like 2000 XP for eliminations, which is way more than you'd get in the normal battle royale mode. So yeah, the XP is buffed on certain maps. You'll just have to test out some of the maps and see which ones you like for XP, but XP and creative might be the way to go this season. The way you know if a map has XP or not is if when you click on it, there will be a little XP mark where it says 16 max players and battle royale and like the different mode types, there will be a little XP sign. Honestly, I think this is such a good change for the game. I think it's a better way to give XP to people who play creative than what we had before. Before, it would just be based on playtime. You get a certain amount of XP. But I think this is a way better system because it rewards you more fairly for what you do. Like, if you're not doing good, you're not going to get as much XP. But if you're playing really good, you're going to get more XP. So you get rewarded for the things you do rather than just sitting in creative, which I think is a pretty good change. And I like that you're getting XP for the map specifically. But anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Comment down below what level you are so far in the season. And if you did enjoy this video, make sure you smack that like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm out, dudes. Peace.